This is a case of twin pregnancy. The patient is in severe discomfort, pain and stress. These are the both babies. No dividing amniotic membrane is seen at this point. The placenta is posterior. The first thing we notice is grossly increased amniotic fluid. The amniotic fluid index is measured in four quadrants. The largest pocket is 10.2 cm and amniotic fluid index is 38.2 cm. This is grossly increased. These are the gestational age measurements of the first baby. All the measurements, BPD, head circumference, abdominal circumference are 26 plus weeks of gestational age. This is normal. The color and Doppler SD ratio is 2.8. This is also normal. This is the second baby. The second baby is not moving at this point. This appears to be fixed in the upper quadrant posteriorly. This is gross IUGR. BPD is 21 weeks and 6 days. Head circumference is 21 weeks and 5 days. Abdominal circumference is 20 weeks and 1 day. Color Doppler shows loss of diastolic component. So this is decreased placental perfusion. Careful evaluation of second baby shows tight membrane covering the baby. Largest pocket is 1.2 cm. So this is diamniotic monochorionic twins with severe polyhydramnios around the first baby and severe IUGR and severe oligohydramnios around the second baby. This is twin-to-twin transfusion syndrome, TTTS. It occurs in about 10-15% of monochorionic pregnancies. There is imbalance of blood flow due to placental vessel connections. In simple words, one baby gets less blood and less food and develops oligohydramnios and IUGR. The other baby, which gets more blood and more food, develops polyhydramnios and increase weight later. This is a serious complication in most of the advanced cases that are diagnosed early and don't receive treatment. The both babies die. In about 80-90% of cases that receive treatment, only one survive and other baby die. In about 50% of less severe cases that receive treatment, both babies survive. Twin-to-twin transfusion syndrome occurs typically between 16 to 26 weeks of gestational age and can be diagnosed with ultrasound scan. Thanks for watching the video.